Texas. With us on the phone right now, Donald Trump from Florida. And sir, good morning to you, and thanks for calling in.
Good morning.
What do you think about these Obamacare headlines?
Well, I think it's a disaster, and I've been saying it from the time before they even voted for it. I said, this is a plan, can't work. It's going to be a disaster. It was a big lie. That's how they got it passed. He said, keep your doctor, keep your plan, and it turned out to be a lie. He said it 28 different times. It's a terrible plan. It's a disgrace that we even have to talk about it, frankly. It should be repealed and replaced, and if I'm elected, we're going to repeal it, replace it with something much better, and much less expensive. It doesn't even work because, frankly, you're paying, and the number of 25% is nothing. That's a phony number, too. That's a lie, just like everything else. It's increasing in Texas. I saw you were just talking about Texas. Well, I think we're doing very well, actually. But in Texas, they're going to have a 60% increase. And in many states, they're going to have 78 and 80% increases. And that's this year. Next year, it's going to be worse. So it has to be repealed and replaced.
Okay.
There's so many alternatives that are so good and so much less.
Let's talk about the best alternative in your view is what? What would you do?
Well, you can go, health care savings accounts are phenomenal. You get rid of the border lines between states, which has to be done because right now the insurance companies have monopolies, which is what they wanted. And frankly, it should have been done last time, but Obama got a lot of money from the insurance companies, so he didn't do it. But you have now competition. If you do that, you'll have tremendous competition. And we will have plans that are so good and plans that people aren't even thinking about right now. They'll be tailor-made. They'll be phenomenal and much less expensive. These plans, you can't even use them because they're so expensive. But not only that, the deductible is so high, nobody gets to use the plan. I mean, unless you're literally on your last legs, unless you're, it's just crazy. The deductible is so high that unless you have a really major problem, and even then probably, you don't get to use them. So you really don't even have them.
A moment ago at your event in Florida, we were watching it live here in New York. You said that it's costing jobs within your business itself. Specifically, how?
Well, I don't use much Obamacare, I must be honest with you, because it's so bad for the people and they can't afford it. And like, for instance, I'm at Trump National Doral in Miami, and we don't even use Obamacare. We don't want it. The people don't want it. And I spend more money on health coverage, but we don't use it. So, you know, when they interview those people, they're very happy with their health coverage. That's because they work for me. I have, you know, great employees, and I take care of my employees. But the people that have to use, they're forced to use Obamacare, it's catastrophic. It's a disaster. It's a disaster for them. They can't afford it. And you know what else? The country can't afford it. Believe it or not, it's on both ends. The country can't afford it, and the people can't afford it. Because if you look next year, that will be one of the biggest line items. I mean, that gets up there when you talk about defense and you talk about some of the budgets. This Obamacare, as bad as it is going to destroy the country.
Donald, Martha McCann, good to have you with us today.
Hillary Clinton wants to double up and keep it going. And just on that, I don't see how she could possibly win an election. But she wants to double up. She wants to keep it going. She wants to raise taxes of everybody to keep it going, put hundreds of billions of dollars into it, and it's a death wish. It's just a pure death wish. Yeah, I mean, look, she has bad judgment. We all know that. So this is just another example of it.
Mr. Trump, good morning. It's Martha McCallum here.
Hi, Martha.
To have you with us. Hi there. You got 14 days to go, and this race is tighter than many believed it would be at this point. What are you planning to do to close this gap and to get in a much better position as you head into November the 8th? What's your plan?
Well, we're very close to winning, I think. You know, the IBD poll just came out, and we're 2 points up, and that was the only poll that very closely predicted every election, every presidential election, the last three cycles, the last three, and predicted everyone and within a tiny margin. So they were the best poll. And they just came out yesterday and they said that we're 2 points up. I think that I think we're doing fantastically. A couple of these polls, like CNN, they poll heavily Democratic, which is ridiculous.
But there are more Democrats in the country than Republicans. So some pollsters say that you have to have a mix that is a little bit more weighted towards Democrats to get an accurate poll.
More than a little bit. But I think we're doing really well. Other polls came out. You saw Rasmussen just came out, and we're doing great there. I think we're doing great. And I can tell you, I'm in Florida right now, and you can't get to a machine. I mean, the polls, they're packed. the polling areas, the polling booths, they're packed. They have lines going a block long, two blocks long, and nobody's ever seen that, especially for early voting. Now, I don't know what this means, but they're all wearing Trump hats and Trump buttons and Trump shirts, so I think that's generally good news. Never know.
Do you have, you know, we were just talking to Chris Darwalt a little while ago, and he talked about sort of the strongest moment so far in your campaign in September. You were very focused on the issues, and then things happened between September and now that sort of got you off track. You know, he said you shouldn't really be talking about the polls
being rigged. But I just want to let people know I'm innocent, okay? Nothing ever happened. It didn't exist. This was all fantasy land. So I do think I have an obligation to myself and my family to say I'm innocent. So that's all I say. I'm innocent. And I did nothing. These were made up tales. Actually, they were made up tales, just like when you remember the violence, and we actually spoke about it once with Bill and you. Remember the violence at my rallies? And I said I couldn't understand where these people are coming from. These were violent people. Well, it just came out 3 days ago on the tape where the violence was caused by Hillary Clinton's campaign, where they were paying people $1,500 and a cell phone to go in and create tremendous violence, hit people, punch people. And, you know, you had police officers that were taken away in ambulances and things. This was terrible. It just came out that this was planned violence by the Clinton campaign and the DNC. Well, I think the other were set up also. So I don't mention it at all. I want to talk about jobs. I want to talk about repealing and replacing Obamacare. But I do want to at least state my innocence.
You have four events today in Florida.
Right.
That is a must-win for you, correct?
Right. I believe Florida is a must-win, and I think we're winning it. I think we're winning it big.
29 electoral votes. You can't go to the White House unless you win in Florida. You would concede that, right?
I think that's probably true. I mean, I'm not.
If you
I'm
look
not,
at the path,
you know, sitting down and figuring other alternate plans, I do believe we're doing well in other states. So we're doing great in Ohio. We're doing great in Iowa. We're doing. I think we're doing very well in New Hampshire. I think we're doing, honestly, I think really well all over. People
It appears, Mr. Trump, that you can look at some of the early voting results and you can find some good news for you and you can find some good news for her depending on where you look. But when you, coming off of your 100-day speech at Gettysburg on Saturday, it seemed the headline that came out of there was that you're going to sue the women, as we were just referring to in a moment.
Well, I know. That's why I'd like to get off that subject.
Everybody
brings that up. But
yeah,
the fact is that, you know, that was a speech talking about Obamacare, and we have to repeal it and replace it, talking about jobs, talking about the fact that we have to stop our companies from leaving our country, going to Mexico and other places, and hiring other than our people. Our job situation is a disaster, and our good job, meaning the good jobs, are disappearing from our country. And those are the things that I talk about.
So when you think about the last debate, whether it's Obamacare, which is a huge headline today, and I know you're going to drive this forward, we just watched your event last hour, is that your focus now?
Bill, I think you know that Obamacare has been a focus of mine for a year and a half since I announced. I mean, I've been saying it's no good. I said it was no good when it first came out. But Obamacare, this isn't new to me. You know, Obamacare has been a focus of mine since I first, literally, Bill, since I first ran. One of my earliest speeches was about Obamacare, what a disaster it is. And I said it was going to blow up, and I said it would blow up in 16 or 17, and that's what's happening. It's blowing up. It's out of control. It can't be saved, and Hillary Clinton wants to save it. And the only way she's going to save it is just to throw literally trillions of dollars at it, and you can't do that.
Donald, there's a lot of evidence that the FBI went easy on Hillary Clinton during the investigation, and now we have this story that $500,000 was spent for a state Senate campaign by Terry McAuliffe on the spouse of a person who went on to investigate Hillary Clinton in the email. What would you do if you were elected? What kind of action would you take to hold the FBI accountable?
Well, let me just tell you, Terry McAuliffe is the single closest person to Bill and Hillary Clinton. There's nobody closer. Terry McAuliffe, they gave to the FBI person at the high level who was doing the investigation, who was in charge of the investigation. They gave his wife $600,000. Now, you think of that. Now, that's Clinton giving the money, because that's how close they are. So Clinton gave the FBI agent, who was top person, who is the top person in charge of her email case, which is a disgrace that she got off of that. She lied to the FBI, she lied to Congress, she lied to everybody. And look what they did to General James Cartwright, a great man, a four-star general. They destroyed his life. He's going to go to jail perhaps for 5 years. She gave money at a huge clip, $675,000, to the wife of the FBI agent who was in charge of her investigation. Let me tell you something. That's a criminal act.
One last question for you, Mr. Trump. You've got 14 days to change the trajectory of this election. You have said that if you lose, it will be the biggest waste of time and money in your life. Do you have any regrets about the way that you've run the campaign, and what do you plan to change over the next 2 weeks?
Well, I can't regret when I started off with 17 and now I'm down to one person. I mean, I had to beat 17 people. We had a total of 17, really 18, and one. And, you know, I think I'm winning now. I mean, I think I'm winning right now.
Is that what you believe? Do you think, based on early voting, some of these states where it is razor tight,
right.
do you honestly think that you have the edge despite the polls?
I'm winning in Florida, which I have to win. I think I'm winning in North Carolina from what I hear. I'm polling very well in Ohio. In fact, I'm going to win Ohio. We're doing phenomenally well in Iowa. I think we're either winning or tied. It's going to be very, very close. I mean, the biggest problem I have is the press. The press is extremely dishonest. Without the press, Hillary wouldn't even stand a chance. I mean, the press is totally dishonest and among the most dishonest things I've ever seen. I mean, I'll be honest with you, and I'm not talking about the two of you, by the way, but a big, big preponderance of the press is unbelievably dishonest, and I always knew it was that way, but never to the extent that I've seen.
Okay. Thank you for your time, sir.
Everybody knows it. I mean, the New York Times wrote a story about it. They practically said that, in a sense, they're dishonest. You know, they said that they don't care. They're going to write negatively no matter what it takes. They're going to write negatively about Trump. And the good news is they won't be in business for more than another three or 4 years because they're losing so much money. But in the meantime, we have to put up with these people. These are very dishonest people.
Three more rallies today in Florida. Sir, thank you for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Trump.
Thank you very much.
Donald Trump wants to be the president 14 days ago. Thank you again. About 20 minutes now past the hour. So in a moment here, we find another Clinton IT specialist taking the fifth, not answering questions in a deposition about Clinton's private server. You will not believe how many times this person pled the fifth. We'll have that story for you.
And an extreme athlete following in Forrest Gump's footsteps, running clear across the entire country, and he did it in record time. We will talk to him, Bill, coming up live in just a few minutes.
Man.
Stick around.
Hold on.